All right, I want you to take a look at these three sentences and let me know which one of them do you find the easiest to read. Is it the first one, which is in Times New Roman, the second, which is in Arial, or the third, which is in Comic Sans? Out of all of them, which one do you find the nicest to look at aesthetically? And are those two answers of yours the same or are they different? Pop them down in the comments. The world of readability and aesthetics in fonts is one that is hugely controversial. And as I've discovered, the story of why Times New Roman specifically is so popular is actually unscientific. So let's dive in. Thanks to my Patreon community for supporting BrainCraft. This journey started when last month I was asked to reformat a research paper I've been working on into Times New Roman. In the 9 months since I started working on it, I descended from using my preferred Helvetica UA to Calibri, because Microsoft Word kept reformatting paragraphs into it, to Times New Roman, what I consider to be the most vanilla of all typefaces. In my despondence, I turned to Instagram and asked, why do academics love Times New Roman? This pinched a nerve, and I received hundreds of emotionally charged responses that span from disgust to support for Times New Roman. Those people are out there. And the same thing kept coming up. Times New Roman is the easiest to read. That serif fonts, those with the little notches at the top, are more accessible than sans serif fonts, those with the straighter lines. I want to add a quick note on pronunciation. It should be serif and sans serif, but I can't say sans serif 10 times with a straight face, so please accept my sans for the purpose of this video. And I started to wonder, is there actually any research on this? What does the research say? And have people who need accessible fonts been consulted in the development of them? Have they actually been asked just what they want? So I emailed some people in Comic Sans because I'm a troll.
Don't judge every typeface for its face value. Don't even judge Comic Sans. I feel like letters have feelings. Type has feelings.
This is Paola, Kassa, a graphic designer, YouTube creator, and my new personal font therapist who can tell us why different fonts are used and chosen in the first place.
Communication is the basis of graphic design. If you can't read it and you're trying to communicate something, then what's the point? Like, as a design rule, you would want to choose typefaces and fonts, and all your choices would be around what the theme of the design is, what works for your design. Legibility, readability, those are really important factors that you want to think about when choosing a design and choosing a font to use.
So how do we know which fonts are the most readable or accessible? These are scientific questions, which takes us into some research. Thankfully, some researchers are exploring the serif versus sans serif debate too. A 2005 study found that serifs make text slightly more legible if it was very small. But at 12 point, there was no difference in accuracy or reading speed between Arial and Times New Roman. Although people said they preferred reading Arial. Though my random Instagram questions show that preferred fonts can get very personal. In another study of 500 people, at Times New Roman and Noto Sans were the most preferred fonts, but they each got only 17% of the vote, meaning there's a lot of variability in people's favorite fonts. No surprises there. And even though most of the people in that study thought that they would read faster in their preferred font, this actually wasn't the case. Some people did read faster in their favorite font, but others read slower. So on average, a preferred font didn't speed up reading rate. But overall, the one finding that is pretty consistent across all of these studies is about font size. Size matters. Multiple studies have found that larger font sizes improve readability and comprehension. So while it's often assumed that fonts with serifs are more readable and accessible than fonts without, research actually doesn't support this. And serifs are also disliked when it comes to an aspect of our communication that is super essential, making sure it's accessible to everyone.
Fonts are interesting conceptually. Fonts are interesting. You could say, I don't know, a font is a work of art.
You may remember Matthew from my video, Lego for the Blind, about a project he started to develop text-only instructions for massive Lego builds. Matthew builds everything you see here, and he was born without vision. But in addition to being a master builder, Matthew is a treasure trove of information about font design for people with visual impairments.
There was a font that's called Tiresias. And this font was developed by a graphic designer for the Royal National Institute of the Blind in the UK. And this font was criticized, but I think it was criticized for either kind of its graphical appeal or its difficulty of legibility. The main criticism that those who have enough vision to read against these fonts is that the more fantastical they are, the more ornaments they have, the difficulty it is to read, because you need to parse out the actual letter from all the fancy stuff around it. And that's straining to the eyes, and it takes up a lot of time.
And fonts like Tiresias, Atkinson Hyperlegible, and A-Font have also been designed for people with visual impairment. But the research on their benefits is not clear. One study looked at the reading speed of people with sight problems using Tiresias, Times New Roman, Helvetica, and Foundry Form Sans. And what they found was that the size of the fonts had more impact on reading speed than the fonts themselves. Having text at 14 point instead of 12 would increase the proportion of the population who are able to read fluently. Similarly, there are fonts designed for people who have dyslexia with the intention of improving readability. But then when researchers actually looked into these fonts, you can probably guess what happened. In two different studies of people with dyslexia, Open Dyslexic didn't improve reading rate. One of those studies also found that Open Dyslexic tied in 10th place out of 12 fonts when readers were asked which fonts they preferred. And in more research, children preferred to read in Arial than Dyslexic. So I will say that all of this research surprised me. I thought that if there was a font designed for people with dyslexia to improve their reading experience, then it would improve their reading experience. But what I've learned is that something that's designed for a certain group of people isn't always generalizable to everybody in that group. Everybody has a slightly different experience. Some people, like accessibility advocate Alex Chen, say that Comic Sans is actually the most readable for people with dyslexia, because in a word like Illinois, you can easily tell the letters apart. So maybe we should just start submitting our work in Comic Sans. I know that a lot of this font research is inconclusive and it kind of fans the flames of this controversy, but we can say that it's a misconception that Times New Roman is more accessible or readable. There is not any data to back that up. So the question remains, why is it so popular in academia? Perhaps an older legacy is just what Times New Roman has going for itself. It was designed by Stanley Morrison for the London newspaper The Times, which is where the Times in Times New Roman comes from, and it debuted as the paper's font in 1932. And it was Microsoft Word's default typeface until 2007, when they changed it to Calibri, which is just a whole other can of worms. For comparison, Arial wasn't invented until 1982, making it a millennial, and good old Comic Sans made its debut in 1994, alongside my Lion King t-shirt. But unlike the timeless joys of Hakuna Matata, we do have worries about Times New Roman. Maybe we just crave the clean lines of a sans serif, or maybe we're resistant to nonsensical rules being forced upon us.
People get really fed up when people tell them that it's a rule and that it's what you have to do. And I think people just get tired of that. And they're like, well, I'm going to make my own rule.
And in making our own choices, there's so many ways that we can communicate and express ourselves.
I think it's very cool that for sighted people, you have a lot of choice in what you can do with your letters and your words. And you can have them be as ornate or vanilla as you want.
But a lot of these characteristics of fonts depend on our own interpretation and perceptions of them. And that's the thing about fonts. Type, like other areas of design, is subjective. So people have a lot of opinions about it. Science can't tell us what font is best, because just like the design of a home, there are certain features that we like and there are others that certain groups need. And this can change a lot from person to person. What research can tell us is that if you want to read text quickly, you should increase the size of that text. And what we know is that people will always have opinions about what they think is best, especially on the internet.
I would say strong, disciplined, agile, and it's tidy. Definitely accessible, clean, digital, and easy. Comic Sans, I think it is childlike, a little ugly, sorry, overused, but also accessible and fun.